spirit of Detroit.
All the champions out there feel so good. Hey, I said it feels so good.
Man, it feels good. Man, yes, back in blue, baby. And it feels great. Hi, my name is Avery Giovanni. This is Spirit of Detroit Podcast. Content from here on out will be clear, concise, ready to go. Your favorite YouTubers are really backing me. And, you know, Mobby, guys like Mobby, Micro Mike, they're really backing me up. And they're really... put me out there, Joe Polo. So shout out to them, man. I see their discussion posts. I see what's going on. The ads and stuff is critical. So I appreciate the love. I appreciate you if you like, comment, subscribe. Appreciate you just for visiting. John Penisini, man, is one of my favorite defensive linemen. I mean, last year, he was a 6th round pick out of Utah, pick 18. He was a difference maker. He was a big difference maker in a couple games. There was a couple Reddit posts on him. He was a run stuffer for me. He was a run stuffer. He did show quickness off the ball, but his primary job was to defend against the run. And during the combine, he had some solid numbers. But Jonathan Penisini was... he was a good pick, but he was playing injured last year. He had a Sith removed from his body, and I think the story is going to go unnoticed by most YouTubers. Dan Campbell says here an article, I know that we've been pleased with Penisini when he came back into camp. His weight, he's in shape, he's passing a condition test. And by the way, he looked like he had softballs on his shoulders. He had that repaired after the season, in fact, and it just looked like a bunch of calcium deposits had been there. You wonder why, when you watched the film last year, he was not using his arm. That's because he had these issues. Penisini, I've actually seen this before. I've seen this in basic training. We had a specialist. He had just graduated college and joined the Army. He had this almost like cyst. I'll put it up on the screen. He had this almost like giant cyst on his right shoulder, and it was expensive surgery to get to just remove that, and that's the first time I had seen it. But he couldn't do certain things, so he had to work harder at it. And we seen that with John Penisini last year. He was a dude who showed up for us. You know, I think John in his later part of the year, early part of the year, he was really jumping out on tape. I remember him getting some push against Carolina. In the Carolina game, he was getting some push, recorded his first sack that game. In addition, he was the one who, in the Chicago game, recovered the fumble that Coria caused. So he wasn't getting that much push, but he was reacting to the ball, which I like. Now he can get push and he can react, and he's quicker than you know. So him being 6'2", 300, over 300 pounds is really going to help him show that explosiveness, show that strength, and he can really be an attacking nose tackle. And that's what I really appreciate about him. So just to know that he's recovered, he's got his injury solved, or his issue solved, as Dan Campbell put it, and plus came in as a bigger guy passing the strength and conditioning test. Yeah, I have nothing but high hopes for this defensive line. This defensive line is probably going to create the most pressure I've seen, or we've seen in the last 2 years. And if we have everybody healthy, we have everybody back from camp in a situation where we're going into the first game completely healthy, and we can flow guys in, rotate. And he's a rotational piece, you know. I think him, McNeil, that's gonna be something hard to solve, you know. Especially if we play a 4-3 man under, where we have two defensive tackles in there, and he can play the two technique or the three technique. It's gonna be a hassle for many teams. So we're gonna get that push. I appreciate comments. Obviously, you guys are winning. Thank you for being here. Thank you for watching the video. I'm gonna give you more news tonight with Luke G, and we'll be talking Lions. All right, this is Spirit of Detroit Podcast. Love y'all.
Shouts out to the Spirit of Detroit Podcast. I had him on my channel yesterday. He is the best Detroit Lions YouTuber. So if I got any Lions fans, make sure y'all go watch and subscribe to the Spirit of Detroit Podcast. And he's just a genuinely good dude, man.